Governor Bevin, thanks for joining us this
afternoon.
In the past week, we've heard from several teachers complaining that you called them selfish. And I know you met with many of them on Monday in Murray. Do you think your comments on that radio program were taken out of context?
I do. I think if you actually listen to what I said, that they were absolutely taken out of context. Nonetheless, there's perception and reality. And I genuinely feel bad for those who feel hurt by the comments that were made, because they were not intended to be directed at teachers. In fact, I very specifically said, out of 75,000 teachers, 70,000 plus fully understand what's at stake and are doing the right thing every day. And then I broke it down as to some of the subset and the handful of that subset that are creating the issues, that are working against the best interest of the whole. And those were the folks that I was speaking to. And I think folks who listened to it in context and in its entirety understood that. Nonetheless, we're all human beings, and people are offended by things. And that's a human reaction and a human right. And I truly feel bad that individuals who may or may not have listened to it in its entirety are hurt by the idea that someone is impugning them as teachers. And as I've said, both my grandmother, my father, siblings, a whole lot of teachers, a whole lot of public education degrees and public school teachers in my family, I fully appreciate the effort people go through to try to teach. I have 8 children in schools right now. And I know sometimes some of my children probably put a little more pressure on the teachers than other ones do at certain points in time. So I just, at this point, the real focus is trying to save a pension system that without it, these teachers will not have something to retire on.
That leads me to my next question. Teachers are rallying in Frankfort and all across the state saying, save our pensions. Our pensions were promised. And you're saying, I am trying to save your pension. Yeah. Were you expecting this backlash?
Here's the problem, and it goes back to what I said, and this runs the risk of making the whole point again. There's a handful of people that are easily misled, and they are being misled intentionally by some for whom the idea of control and power is more important than doing right by the teachers themselves or ultimately the children in the classroom. I am the only governor that has ever fully funded the teachers' pension plan and the other ones as well. I've put more money into the pension system, the teachers' pension system specifically, in my first 2 budgets, than the previous governor that they all supported and loved did in his entire 8 years. The point is, he underfunded them every single time, sometimes less than 50%, and yet they spent millions to get him reelected, millions to support him, millions to elect people who agreed with him and voted on this. Rick Rand, who was the head of appropriations and revenue in the House, and who said that I created the pension crisis, even though I've been governor for 2 years, for 10 straight years, he was there passing budgets that intentionally underfunded it. So you can't argue with people who refuse to be informed of the facts. And the facts are that the Democrat administration that preceded me did a terrible, terrible job of actually taking care of this. I have brought this to the forefront because it has to be addressed. It to continue to kick this and ignore this is to guarantee that it will fail at some point. That's not acceptable.